Welcome to account session once again. In the previous session, we have learned the meaning of goodwill. So, goodwill means, as we have discussed, it is an intangible asset which contributes to the profit earning capacity of a business. It increases the profit earning capacity of a business. So, it is an intangible asset and it contributes to the profit earning capacity of a business. So, why should goodwill be valued? Goodwill is an asset. Any asset means anything that contributes to the earnings of a business. So, goodwill is also contributing or increasing the earning capacity of the business. So, goodwill is considered as an asset. Now, we have seen goodwill depends upon certain factors. So, we have seen yesterday, it may be due to the nature of business. If the nature of business is as such that it has a stable market, which does not have much fluctuations, such businesses will acquire the goodwill or create the goodwill in the short span of time. Whereas, second thing is location. Though your product is best, and though you are ready to provide prompt services and manage the business well, but if your location is not in a legible place, definitely you cannot create much goodwill. There are very less chances that you can create goodwill. But if your location is good, that is in the heart of the city or center of the city, definitely there are many chances that you can create goodwill. So next is management. Efficient management. So, efficient management is a very important part for the creation of goodwill. Feedback should be provided from the customers. Customer grievances should be attended properly. Sound relationship with the suppliers and customers as well. And the prompt payment to the suppliers and prompt services to the customer. These are the things which come under the management. So, if these are efficiently provided, and certainly the goodwill can be created. And next is some special facilities are there for certain business process. Special provisions are given, such as brands or else sometimes subsidy or else import license, etc. If there are high many, some business owners are having some special advantage. In that case, goodwill can be created. And next is market conditions. So, if your market condition provides you with a limited competition or if it provides you with a monopoly, definitely you can create goodwill very soon or in short span of time. But if the competition is tough and if there is no provision for monopoly or etc., then it is very difficult for you to create goodwill. So these are the factors normally on which the goodwill can be created. And next you have seen the methods for valuation of goodwill. So first method was average profit method. So average profit method, what you did is you calculated the average of profits of last few years and multiplied it by years of purchase. Years of purchase means expected years of goodwill. So goodwill will not remain constant throughout the life of the business. It will not continue for 50 years or 40 years because competitors will certainly enter into the market and try to provide better services than us. So goodwill is expected only for few years, like 3 years or 4 years. So we can predict to that extent only. So years of purchase is expected. How many years we can earn extra income or profit than others for number of years that we can expect the extra profit on the basis of goodwill. So you multiply average profits into years of purchase. So yesterday we have seen one problem. Today we will see one more problem based on various prophet Muhammad. But here I will not take all the prophets, sometimes from them certain lag, loss as well. So in case if there is loss, how to calculate the goodwill or how to value the goodwill, let us see in this example now. So here let us consider the profit and losses for the years or 4 years.
Equal to 12,000 is the average profit.
equal to 12,000. Therefore, goodwill equal to average profits into years of purchase. Average profit is 12,000 into years of purchase is how many years is given? 2 years of purchase. 2 years of purchase means 2 years the goodwill is expected to give the returns. So 12,000 into 2 years equal to 24,000 is the value of goodwill. So this is how you will calculate goodwill, or you will value the goodwill in case if there is a loss in certain year while calculating the average profits. So what I have done here is I added all the profits and subtracted the loss, and whatever was the result, I have divided it by total number of years. 1, 2, 3, 4. I have not considered 3 years only. I have considered all the 4 years. So divided it by 4 equal to how much? 12,000 is the average profit, and then 12,000 I have divided it, multiplied into years of purchase. So that it means that the goodwill is about to work or expected to work for next 2 years. So let us see one more problem based on this average profit method. So here actually we will see problem become profit as well as loss. But here the loss has been sustained in the middle. So it has been sustained in the year 2008 and 9. So again in the 2009-10 there is a profit. So altogether the data given is for 5 years, and we will calculate here the value of goodwill under leverage profit method. So let us solve this problem. So we will calculate first what? Average profit. Goodwill is equal to average profit into years of purchase. So let's calculate the average profit here. Average profit equal to total of profit for losses. Now first year there is a profit of 15,000 plus 25,000 plus 20,000. Here there is loss minus 15,000 plus 15,000 divided by 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 years. 15 plus 20 is 40. 40 plus 20 is 60. 60 minus 15. 45. 45 plus 15 equal to 60,000 divided by 5 equal to 12,000. So average profit is equivalent to 12,000 here. Now we are supposed to calculate what? Goodwill. So goodwill is equal to average profits into years of purchase. Average profit is 12,000 as calculated. 12,000 into years of purchase is 3 years. 3 years equal to 36,000 is the value of goodwill. So goodwill equal to average profit into years of purchase, that is 12,000 into 3 equal to 36,000. So in my next session we will see how to calculate or value the goodwill under weighted average profit method. Thank you.